Hi, this is Tim with the Phone Doctors. Today I'm going to show you how to do a Motorola Atrix HD digitizer replacement. Before we get started, I'll show you the tools you'll need to successfully fix your device. First, you'll need the touchscreen. A metal flat pick. Plastic flat pick. And a T5 screwdriver. Before we get started, we'll take out our SIM card tray, which is located to the left of the device. Pick up like so, and just push down on your SIM card, and it pops out. Like so. If you have a memory card, you'll pop that out as well. In this device, we do not have one. Once that's out, ready to take off the back plates. This back plate is actually, there's 3M adhesive underneath here, touching the battery. So you want to be very, very cautious when you pull this up, not to to pull the battery up as well with it. If you break the battery, their batteries are very, very difficult to find. But it comes apart like so. This one came apart really easy, but as you can see here, 3M adhesive right here. You just want to make sure when you pull it up to get enough pressure with their flat pick, not for this battery not to be pulled up. So now we got mini screws to come out. They're all along the edge here. And then of course your battery terminal screws, which we'll take out later. Okay, so now that you have all your screws going all the way around the end, we'll separate this back plate here. And it unclips just like the battery door did. That part comes off like so. Little red grommet will come off, and we're going to take out our battery. And all the screws on this device, all done by the T5. So just one screw driver will work for this entire device, which is really nice. So now we got the battery loose. Comes out like so. Now the next step, this metal frame right here that holds the board down. We'll need to take those out, which is held down by screws here on the side. We'll start taking those out. Got the screws off. Now this frame, missing one. There we go. Now the frame will come out like so. Just put that off to the side. Now we're ready to unplug our LCD digitizer. This is the digitizer plug-in right here. And here's your LCD, and we'll unplug that as well. So those are off to the side. Now we're going to pull the board up. Just get your plastic pick underneath here, and you're going to kind of lift up on the circuit board. It's the circuit board is a little bit adhesed to the back of the LCD, So you just want to get your pick in there and kind of just start separating. Like so. As you hear it's come apart. And there's your circuit board. Sticky stuff still attached. It's off to the side. This long flex cable right here is your digitizer. You just peel that up like so. And we'll pull the LCD out as well. Get this out of the way for the time being. And it just comes out like so. Now we're ready to take the digitizer off the frame and apply the new one on. It screens out on there all that well, so you can usually just peel it off. And since this is an all touchscreen phone, there's no buttons, there's no flex cables you have to worry about. Ripping. It's loose, and we'll just funnel the flex cable through this little hole. And now the screen is off. You can. Now that we got the whole, all the 3M adhesive taken off the frame, we're gonna apply new adhesive, which will come with your screen. You're just basically going to cut slivers off and apply it around the new frame. And this will allow your screen to stay in place. Now we got the adhesive laid. Now you're gonna peel the top layer off. Now that we got the adhesive down, one thing I forgot to mention, on your old screen, there's a little layer right here above your ear speaker. You want to pull that off. You can either do the flat pick or your fingernail, and that portion comes off. What that's going to do is going to go right here where your black on your new screen. Like so. Now you'll pull the tape off the back. Take your cable. Put it through the little slot on the frame and weed it through. And set the screen back down. Now, just like you did the top portion of the screen, we're going to do the same thing with the bottom portion, where you peel. This little black strip off. And that portion just attaches here at the bottom. Like so. So now we're ready to reassemble. You have a towel or a rag, you can take a towel or a rag and you can clean off your LCD, make sure there's no dust, fingerprints on it, as well as the back end of your digitizer. Just blow on it and stick the LCD back into place. Now the back of the digitizer, this flux cable has a few strips right here. These bold blue strips you can pull off, and this what this is going to do is it's going to hold the flux cable in place. There it is. Now we'll grab our circuit board, lay it back into place. It's got a few clips, just lay it back down there, plug your digitizer and your LCD back in, grab your metal frame, and lay that down. Now we'll put our silver screws back in. Now that we got all our screws back in to hold the frame down, we're going to insert the battery. If you find this video very helpful, definitely like us on our YouTube channel. Subscribe to us. If you have any questions at all, concerns, or if you would like to purchase the screen from us for the Atrix HD or other parts, you can always get those on our website, phonedoctors.com. Make sure these battery contact screws are tight. If they're not tight, the phone will not power on properly. Now we got that back on. Grab our little red grommet piece here, rubber grommet. Just place that over the battery contacts, like so. Now we're ready to put the back frame back on. What you want to do is push the camera back down into place. And it clips all the way around, like so. Now we'll put our black screws around the trim and we are almost finished. Now that all the screws are back in, we can place our battery door back on. This clips on all the way around. Insert our SIM card and clips in. Insert our power button. And And there it is. And that is how you successfully fix a Motorola Atrix HD digitizer. And thanks for joining us. Thanks. Have a good day. Take a trip to my heart.